And we need these two, the rubber band, a tool to lock the chains. So I'll show you how to install it on the trailer. To install the chain trailer, this is what you have to do. So here's the chain with the locks. With the locks, it needs to be, you know, on this side. And this is supposed to be on the other side. Make sure that this link pointing up. Because if it will point down, then it will blow, like, it will blow the tire. So we spreading the chains. Just make sure all the locks are open. Put it under the trailer tire and back up about like a couple of feet back. When you back up, so it's supposed to be looks like this kind of situation, just like so. So after it, what we need to do next? When you backed up with your trailer, make it this straight, and then let's straight the bottom section, or so straight it and put it on a like third link, just like so. Go over here and let's straight it here. Everything looks straight. Put it on a third link. And clockwise, we need to lock. Okay. Looking good. So we need to take a rubber bungee cords, go here, so we'll go here and here. Let's go here, here, and so this will not wobble around. You need to put it like this way, like this, so the lock is gonna look, so it will not touch the anywhere here, and we looks like we're good to go. So it will tell, So if the one lock will unlock or something, it will be wobbly. So with the Banshee, it will kind of hold together. And after we're done with the chains, then we need to take everything down. So bungee cords, then take your key and counter clockwise. One link here. Take the chain down. And you can drive forward or backward. And I will just back up. So after we're done with the chain, we need to look for if there is any broken links. All looks good. And we can put it away now. So that's the simple way to install the chain on a trailer. The locks to be outside and this part is need to be outside. Looks like this kind of setup. So now we need to put, we need to connect one end of chain to the other end. Okay, now we need to connect those two ends of chains, top and bottom. So first we need to do the inside hook. Go from inside and hook it up for the second link. Kind of pull it and the first link here. Let me see if we can do it on a second link. I doubt it, but maybe it will work. No, it's too far. So the first link looks tight enough. Clockwise here, clockwise here, and clockwise. So it's very snug now. Yep, looking good. Now we need to get the rubber part. So just make sure you don't hook for this side. No, move it right here. So these two, then these two, and this one. So it looks all the locks are locked, chain is tight, you're good to go. So it should look like this. So after we're done with the chains, take it all down, and we need to loose our locks counterclockwise. Loose this side, and then we need to dig right here another lock. Put the chains on the side, and we need to move forward. So it doesn't really matter if you'll go forward or backwards. So what you need to do next? We need to inspect our chain, if there is any broken links, if there is any, then you need to tell your company that one of the chains have a broken link or anything, so your truck will be ready for next trip. So after we're done, we need to go in and hang them. Just like so, go on every single hook, keep going, then the last hook, and turn around, keep going, and hook it right here. Then you have a hook here, just, okay, so now it's all hooked, it will not go anywhere. So this is the best setup for the for the chains. Easy to take them off and put them back together.